God is ready.
Guys, game, guys.
Hello.
What is the events department? The events department is the umbrella arm of AGBA. We are in charge of implementing the different projects in accordance with the different departments. So, like in events, this is what we have, you know. Wow, amazing. We have great projects, and what can I possibly offer to this department?
Well,
I have a vision. I see AGBA 2, 3, or even 4 years from now as the organization to join in the Ateneo. Our events, left and right, are perfect examples of what other orgs are supposed to strive for. Bondings, parties, conference, bazaars, you name it, AGBA's got it. I want people to see AGBA's members, the AVP, the force, as passionate, fun, hardworking, and amazing leaders inside and outside the organization. So, above all, I want people to see AGBA as the premier marketing organization in the university, one that markets events excellence. So, what are my objectives? My objectives are driving the force behind AGBA and reinforcing the event structure. See, as the people here, some of you guys are force members, some of you guys were force members, and a lot of you are aspiring to be force members in the future. You guys are the committee heads, the project heads, the mentors, the FASCs, and you are the forefront of the organization. You guys will be the leaders of AGBA. And I want to help you guys. So, first will be the Force 101. The Force 101 will be a manual with all the tips and tricks, all the trade secrets that AGBA needs for the Force members. Apart from that, I want to complement it with committee-specific bootcamps. This will help you guys get a better grasp, get a better understanding on what a force member being entails, what being a committee head or a project head being entails. The truth is, you guys, the subhead, the subcore, you guys are only exposed to an aspect of a certain committee, yet next year, you'll be committee heads, you'll be project heads, and you'll be expected to lead AGBA's members and force members. And when that time comes, I want to equip you guys with the necessary skills to lead AGBA as force officers. Events trainings. I want to create a more accessible events bootcamp. The events bootcamp we have only caters to 30 people, but I want it to be more inclusive rather than exclusive. This will be a series of talks and workshops that will be done by the events department throughout the year, and it's open to force and regular members. And lastly, I want to strive for an HR-oriented force. I don't want to see AGBA as just work. I mean, it isn't. Why do people join organizations? Because they love it. They like the people. They like what the organization is for. And this should start with our own officers. I don't want people to get stressed out. I don't want people to feel that AGBA is just a chore. Because it isn't. AGBA is family. So I also want to reinforce the event structure with an events database. The events database will basically be a record of all of our different events, along with the task description of each committee per event. I think you guys would agree that launch programs is not AIMS programs. Launch programs, you're looking for DJs. AIMS programs, you're talking to a company. And that's very different. We market our events amazingly outside the organization. But can we honestly say that each and every one of our members, each and every one of our force members, knows the events in and out, what each committee actually does for each event in AGBA? I also want to create a project management system. First would be identical tracker system to make it so that events will be easily tracked. Second, I want to create a project deliverable calendar. And this will make sure that the events department will act as an invisible hand. We will make sure that no committee gets left behind in any event. Lastly, I want to focus on AGBA's culture. I'm sure you guys, in one way or another, have experienced this. I don't want people to get stressed a lot because of things that we clutch. AGBA's events are going to get bigger and bigger each year, and we have to find a more efficient working system around it. Else, people will just get tired year in and year out, which is one of the biggest problems of AGBA. So, lastly, I have two new project initiatives, which is the TEDx Salon and the Marketing Week. TEDx Salon is an extension of the TEDx ADMU, and Marketing Week is basically a week geared towards marketing education in Ateneo. So, the events department has been a lot of things for me. You know, I've grown here. It's been a friend. It's been a mentor. It's been a teacher. It's been a goal. It's been an inspiration. And throughout my journey in Ajmer. It's actually through the events where I met the different people here in Ajmer, the amazing people in this organization, as well as me growing in Ajmer in ways I could never have imagined as a freshie. I mean, I wouldn't have expected I would be here right now. However, it was through these that I actually excelled in Ajmer, and I believe that with my experiences in the past 3 years and the things I have learned in Ajmer, it is my turn to step up. It is my turn to bring the events department. No, to bring Ajmer to greater heights. And I want to share that with you. I want you guys to be part of my Ajmer next year. Again, my name is Nathaniel Benedicto, running as your next Vice President for Events.
Guys, this is it.
Okay. What are the qualities needed as an event vice president? And then describe yourself. How do you plan on marrying the team in this achievement?
Thank you for the question, Ariana.
I believe that being an events VP, you have to be, well, for lack of better words, all knowing. You have to know what's happening with each and every event. And I believe that as an events VP, you have to be partial to all the different events. You have to know what's best for the organization. I believe that I know the line between work and play, and I know how to manage when I'm working and when I'm not with friends. And I believe this is something that as an events VP we have to know how to do.
Hi, Bene. Your platform is very HR oriented, which is a good thing. Given that, why didn't you just run for HR instead, given that you're capable for the position anyway?
Thank you for that.
I believe that, you know, a common misconception of events is that events is just events. Events is work. And this is something that I believe is a flaw in Ajmer right now. Because you can't really separate the people and the events. And for your question, why I did not run for HR, I believe that my HR approach for events is something that Ajmer needs right now. I believe that these things that I want to apply for events, I couldn't have done it if I was an HR VP. Because, you know, this HR approach in events can only be done as an events VP. Things that, you know, wait, thank you.
How do you see the HR department functioning, especially since a lot of your points really delve into what the current HR department does anyway? So the current HR initiatives are in line with your events platform. So I don't know your HR department. Based on how are you gonna run your department?
HR has member training, and for me, my platform is focused on force training. If you look at the constitution, the EVP has the JMOs, the JMOs, the PR has PR elite, creative directors under the home department. So each one has their like mini self. And for the events, according to the constitution, it's events department, events AVP, events VP, events AVPs, project heads, and committee heads. So according to the constitution, the force are under the events department, and I believe that it is, you know, their training and whatever we're gonna do with them. So since everything relates to the success of the event at the end is under our jurisdiction.
So what's the HR?
Not too
late.
Never.
It's related to the question. Let's give
Jake. Some of the force officers you worked with tell us that Kyron, you weren't as involved as you are in them. For example, with Bazaar or with Ajimi, you weren't as involved, you weren't as present. So, given that you're ready for events, how can you guarantee us that you will give the same effort, the same interest in other projects as you do with them?
Well, I believe I really showed my dedication through the different things I did. In Ajmer Week, I was actually the logistics head to secure the sec field for Ajmer Week. And as you can see, in Summit, I was, well, best Fassi, and I was really... I was in the Big Red Bazaar too, I was actually a finance head, yet I also transitioned as a logistics head near to the event.
Thank you.
independent how the project heads their under events in the Constitution, but that's not their question. The question is, what will HR still do if everything you're doing is already geared towards HR? So you know that in an org structure, all of you have different hats, all of you have different things to fight for. And basically, you're kind of, you know, saying, okay, I'm gonna lessen down first on what events is usually for, which is about making events groundbreaking, breaking boundaries, whatever. But yeah, if you do that, and if you focus on HR, what's gonna happen to that aspect?
I did mention a while ago that HR's thing is usually member training, and I believe that what I'm doing is force training. Apart from that, I believe that HR isn't solely for it was actually mentioned in my platform that for my HR-oriented force and my different different initiatives for the force members, I actually said that in relation to the HR department. So this won't be solely an events department initiative. This is something that I want to work along with the HR department.
Sorry, can I jump off the question?
What are your initiatives then that are solely for the events department? Something that if I hear about it, oh, events. It's not like events, it's events.
I guess the main one would be the Azure Red Book. This has been something that has been in the platforms of the past events VPs for the past 4 years since Max Start, I believe. However, it is something that was never fully accomplished. Ariana was the closest, seeing as she released the first part at the start of the year. And this is something I want to tackle. That's why in my platform, I really specified what I wanted in the events in the Red Book. One would be the Force 101, and the second one would be the events database. I believe another initiative that's solely on events would be the new marketing project, which is the marketing week, and apart from that, the project management system, which I will be doing it as a event VP.
What makes you say that the biggest problem in ACMA this year is that the forests are underappreciated?